Now, before understanding where to file a check bounce case, it is better to understand the territorial jurisdiction of the courts. Now, every court will have a territorial jurisdiction, a limited jurisdiction. It will not have unlimited jurisdiction. And the jurisdiction will be limited to one mandal or two mandals. So, this is the territorial jurisdiction of the courts. For the civil and the criminal, there will be territorial jurisdiction that will be prescribed by the High Court of the particular state. And court can operate only to that particular jurisdiction, which will invariably be a mandal or two mandals or three mandals depending upon the population. So, if this is clear, I will come to the next aspect. Now, I will better explain this with an illustration. The accused has a bank account in Chennai. The complainant has a bank account in Hyderabad. But the complainant works in Bengaluru. The complainant, let us assume that he is having an account in State Bank of India. Now, State Bank of India will have a branch in Hyderabad and Bengaluru also. But to be more specific, it will be limited to a particular mandal or tehsil, whatever the name it is called in your state. So it will not be in Hyderabad. Entire Hyderabad, the branch will not be in entire Hyderabad. The branch will be located in a mandal. Okay. So now, as I had earlier said, the court has territorial jurisdiction pertaining to one or two mandals or three mandals. Now, in whichever mandal the bank is located, that mandal is under the control of a particular criminal court. So, therefore, if the check gets bounced in a bank in that mandal, then it comes into the territorial jurisdiction of the criminal court to which that mandal is attached. Hope I am clear. So, if the complainant presents the check in Hyderabad in a mandal called A, now he has to file a check bounce case in a criminal court where the jurisdiction of the mandal A exists. In the same way, if he sends the check for collection from Bengaluru, even then he must file a check bounce case only in the mandal A. He can't file in a mandal where the check is presented in Bengaluru. Eventually, it is tagged to the bank account where it is exactly located, where it is physically located. Virtually, it may be located in Bengaluru, but it is physically located in Hyderabad. So, he has to file in Hyderabad only. Even though he presented the check in Bengaluru for the purpose of collection, because he works in Bengaluru, he has to file a check in Hyderabad. Check bounce case in Hyderabad. This is one aspect, if it is sent for collection. Okay. Now, coming to second aspect, if it is presented across the counter in a bank of the accused. Now, in the second instance, he has to file a check bounce case in Chennai, in the mandal. Let us call the mandal B in Chennai. Now, the bank of the accused is located in a particular mandal. That mandal has a territorial jurisdiction of a criminal court. Comes within a territorial jurisdiction of a criminal court. So, therefore, he has to file the check bounce case in the criminal court particular, which has a territorial jurisdiction of mandal B in Chennai. So, hope I am clear. If you have any doubts, kindly ask in the comment section. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.